be able to take a person from being a brainstem phenomena literally at birth and bring them into literally being a god or goddess with all 8 segments of their brain developed over a period of time. And that is not the approach. Education is not approached at all scientifically. It's approached from an economic trade perspective. And that's why you have people dropping down between the cracks, because the teachers are not even there for that. They're trying to download some information to get them ready for a job. They're not interested in developing this person's brain, because you have to start with what you come in with. So if a child basically has had neurologic repression because of a depressed environment, then of course he needs to be in a special environment for that. He needs not to be labeled as anything other than the fact that if he's in first circuit, and normally, majority-wise, most children come to school with second circuit brain activity skills, then he just needs to be put in a classroom that deals with making sure that that first level of brain circuitry is complete. And for those out there who have done any work in true innovative neuroscience know exactly what I'm talking about. Most people have not been exposed to this type of information about the anatomy of the brain, because when you begin to find out what circuits you live your life through, et cetera, you'll recognize the danger of you settling for and joking about the fact that it's okay for you to only have 10 to 20% of your brain activated. You would be quite upset about that if you understood what that does to the quality of your life, and you get very busy having somebody get you some answers so that you can bump up your brain function.
End of CD 1 of RealBlackTalk.com. Interview with Dr. Jewel Pookrum. Yes, as I sit here at Brown Student Radio archiving this interview with Dr. Jewel Pookrum, this interview was done in 2000. Today is May 23rd, 2006. Has any of the information changed in 7 years? Are we still walking around using only 2 circuits of 8 circuits of our brain? And FYI, since that was almost 7 years ago, her email information and contact information has changed. You can locate Dr. Jewel Pookrum at drjewelpookrum.com. Yes, she has her own website and radio show, The House of Jewels, the Owner's Manual for the Human Body, the official website for Dr. Jewel Pookrum. And so now, what are we listening to again? And do we progress here? I know I'm working on it. And what helps you progress?
I had already.
1, 2, 3. Let's go. RealBlackTalk.
.com.
RealPeople.com.
Real issues.
RealBlackTalk.
Beginning of CD 2.
Dr. Pookrum,
yes.
Why isn't some of the things that you're saying, why should we not look at this as, say, reverse scientific racism, if you will, like what they did in the 19th century, how these scientists used race as a mechanism to perpetrate medical and scientific discrimination against whole masses of people?
Well, I mean, you can choose to do that, but is that going to give you what you want? If I'm telling you that you need to activate more brain tissue, and if you want to look at life and what people have done to you as being oppressive and have held you back, then that probably is going to set you back for years before you can finally get up enough interest and redirect your focus to what is most important. Because when you have enough brain tissue activated, they can't do that to you. That's the point.
Mm-hmm.
Is that when you expand your consciousness, oh, you can see people coming before you can see them with your eyes.
Yeah, you know.
You can hear people coming before you can hear them with your ear. because you now have moved and developed higher circuits of the brain that make ESP a reality for you. Everybody has the capacity to have extrasensory perception, but not in a society like this that makes you continuously act like you're a reptile.
Now, a final question for you, because as you know, we're winding down here for our time frame on Black Talk Radio. I really do feel honored that I was beneficial enough to be at the Black Bookstore, A Nubian Notion, and come across your book, Vitamins and Minerals from A to Z, and then have the tenacity to track you down from Michigan to Georgia, and Brother R.A. took over from there in terms of contacting you and getting you on as a guest. And we really are appreciative of your knowledge base and your ability to share this information with our listeners and with us. And I'm out of curiosity. I know what it is that they teach you in medical school, and what you're reciting to us now, this is not what they taught you in medical school.
Well, of course not, because I was taught in medical school to be a tool, to be a vehicle, a conduit, to ensure that the patient, the pharmaceutical companies, the insurance companies, and the hospitals all got paid. That's what I was taught in medical school. And if the patient got better, good. But if not, at least the pharmaceutical companies, the hospital, and the insurance companies going to get paid.
Well,
and that's not what I went to medical school for. And since they didn't give me what I went for, I was not going to be deprived of what my intent was. And this is what I'm saying, is that, you know, the medical schools did what they did. They did a good job. I understand their perception of medicine very well. But it's inadequate relative to what can be. And I'm not going to settle for what is when I know what it can be. And so I'm saying that that's why it's very important that if people have done research inadvertently to control folks, et cetera, do you want to settle for that, or do you want to go ahead and go to the vision? Because anything you can envision, you can have. And that's how everything on this planet gets created,
no doubt,
by the vision first. So I don't have time to spend on foolishness. All I know is that there are many more physicians out there like me who want to be able to really have people move beyond the appearance of limitations, et cetera, so that we can literally have, quote, heaven in earth. And the key that is so mystifying to me is that you can get paid for it. So therefore, my colleagues who are in these hospitals telling people that they're going to have to die, telling people what they can't do, they can get paid just as well for helping people and giving them the information as to how they can move beyond the illusion of the limitation that they have at the moment.
So you move beyond the Hippocratic Oath to the Imhotep Oath?
I guess I did. I was really impressed with the Hippocratic Oath, and I tell people now that when I took that first statement into my mouth and recited it, first do no harm, that has been the platform that I have stood on. First do no harm. It is not acceptable to me to think that it's okay that you can give people stuff that kills them, their cells off, makes them puke and vomit, takes all their hair out, puts them in the bed, and takes them to near death before they can get better. No, I'm not accepting that.
Well, let's talk about...
And that's known as chemotherapy.
I know, and radiation. And to talk just briefly about what it is that your services are, you have integrated medical services, you do live cell analysis, you do something called Mammodermacure.
Right, that's a preventative treatment for breast tissue, because my goal is to see cancer become the incidence of 1 in 1 million women instead of 1 in 8. And the only way that can happen is through prevention. Prevention is the foundation for that. There's no drug that's going to do that. It's prevention. So I don't care how much vaccine they gave out. If the streets were still nasty, if we basically didn't wash our hands, if we were not using a better pulmonary toilet, smallpox and everything else would still be very much alive.
Indeed. You also deal with nutrition, hydrocolon therapy, myomassage.
That's correct.
And GNLD, multi-nutrient guidelines. We didn't get a chance to get into what that was.
Yeah, because just like any hospital or any clinic, they have a formulary or pharmacopoeia where they basically dispense nutrients, or in their case they call it drugs, that are used to assist in the treatment of disorders. So GNLD is our pharmacopoeia. Okay, that we use, which is a line of high-quality, excellent nutrients, minerals and vitamins and whole foods to help sustain healing.
You also have healthy cooking classes on and deal with weight loss, lifestyle support for emotional and mental growth and development.
Right. And most of all, tissue regeneration. So, yes.